Good morning, my boys and girls. How are you all? All my dear ones are good and everything is fine and all are praying daily during this lockdown. So let us start our class with a small prayer. So kneel down, join your hands and close your eyes. Lord, thank you for this wonderful day. I thank you, Jesus, for each and every children as we gather here to praise you and worship you. While I'm telling the word, you please be with me and every child and give them understanding, power and wisdom. You guide me while I'm teaching your word. In Jesus' most precious name of Jesus Christ, we ask this small prayer. Amen. Children, before going to the story, I request everyone kindly sit down with your book, Bible and pen so that you can note any important notes which I tell you. So, I'll show you a picture of the title of our story. I know you all are brilliant students. So, kindly observe the picture and frame the title of the story. Yes, you all got it right. The story goes like this. God hears the cry of the children. Let us all open our Bibles to Genesis chapter 21, beginning from verse 9 to 21. Today, I'll be telling you a story about Hagar and Ishmael. Long, long time passed, Abraham and Sarah did not have any children as God has promised them. Sarah was impatient, so she sent her maid Hagar to Abraham and said, "Have a baby with Hagar. If she has a son, we can raise him." Hagar and Abraham had a baby boy and named him Ishmael, but he was not a God's plan. Few days later, this Sarah had a son just as God promised. She named him Isaac, which means laughter. Remember, Sarah had laughed when God said she would have a baby once Isaac was born. Sarah became jealous of Hagar and his son. One day, Abraham made a party for young Isaac, where Sarah heard Ishmael making fun of Isaac. She was very, very angry and sent Hagar and her son away. She told Abraham, "I don't want Ishmael to share my Isaac inheritance." This made Abraham very upset. Ishmael was his son too. God told Abraham that it is okay to send Hagar and Ishmael away. Isaac is the promised son, God said. "Well, I have promised to watch over Hagar and Ishmael. I will make a nation of the son of the slave woman because he is your offspring." Next day, Abraham got up early in the morning and gathered food, water for Hagar to take. She and Ishmael left. He was sad to send them away. Hagar and Ishmael wandered for many days and had nowhere to go. The soon water they brought ran out. Hagar left Ishmael sitting in the shade of the bush and walked short distance away from him. Sat down and thought to herself, "I can't stand and watch my son dying," and tears rolled down her face. Meanwhile, Ishmael was crying. God heard him. God's angel came to Hagar and said, "Don't be afraid, Hagar. God has heard your son cry and promised to make him into a great nation. Go and comfort your child." Suddenly, a well appeared in front of Hagar full of water. She filled the jar and gave Ishmael to drink. Year passed, Ishmael grew up to become a strong young man and he married an Egyptian woman. So, did you all enjoy the story? So, in this way, the boy cries to the God and he will hear the cry of the boy and helps him. In the same way, when you ask Jesus for any help, he will provide you. Whatever you need, you should ask and never forget to thank him again. So, we all need to pray for the situation which we are going through. We should pray for the high authorities, the people who are affected with coronavirus, the doctors, nurses and the pastor. And the people in Vizag who are affected due to leakage of harmful poisonous gases are suffering today now. We should remember them in your daily prayers. So children, I believe you all will pray and cry to the Lord and he will hear your cry. So children, let us learn the memory verse now. When righteous cry for help, the Lord hears and delivers them out of their trouble. Psalm 34:17. Children, let us end our class with a small prayer. Thank you, Lord, for this time which you have given. Lord, remember each and every children and protect them and their families. In Jesus' most precious name, we ask this small prayer. Amen.